Well, if you're planning to buy property in Mumbai, there's good news for you. In a crucial move ahead of the BMC elections, Maharashtra Chief Minister Uddhav Thackeray has announced a property tax waiver for all those who are planning to buy property below 500 square feet. The move is likely to impact about 16 lakh families in the financial capital, and the implementation of the order is expected from January itself. My colleague Ketan joins us to understand the implications of this. Ketan, first of all, there is the economic impact in terms of how it affects people who are looking to purchase property, and there is a political impact as well. Let's just separate the two and start with how this is going to affect potential home buyers.
Well, be it potential home buyers or existing home buyers, if you have a property in the city and if it's below 500 square feet, then it is going to impact you because there is a complete property tax waiver. And this move is going to impact 16 lakh families across the city. The announcement was made a while ago by Chief Minister Uddhav Thackeray in a meeting, in a conference call where the Chief Secretary of the state was present, the Commissioner of Brihanmumbai Municipal Corporation was present, and the Urban Development Minister was present. And he made it very clear to all his officials that this should be implemented strictly, and he wanted to reach out. And he also had a political dig at the opposition, saying that he promises only when he can deliver.
Yeah.
Because, yeah, it is notable that this was one promise that was there in the Shiv Sena manifesto that was released before the 2019 polls.
Ketan, we'll just dig a little deeper into that. But Niranjan Hiranandani, the Vice President of the National Real Estate Development Council, joins us also to understand the implications of this. Mr. Hiranandani, good evening, and wish you a very happy new year. How do you read this development? The real estate sector has been extremely sluggish because of COVID. Do you think this is something that will boost and revive the sector?
No, I think, first of all, you have to understand that it's a fantastic move by the Chief Minister to keep his commitment, which he had put in the manifesto during the election time. There was a lot of issues as to whether it would happen or not, and I'm glad that it has finally been being implemented with immediate effect. I think it's a good thing for the city. You have to understand that the under construction people will not benefit so much, but the affordable housing segment, which I think is going to benefit because we are talking about 500 square feet and low. So yes, that segment will definitely benefit. But the number of people who are residents of Mumbai today, 16 lakh of their houses are benefited. I think that's a stupendous job and a very big gift to the city of Mumbai, which has come from the government of the day. So congratulations to the Chief Minister for doing this particular thing. And there are a huge number of beneficiaries who are going to be very grateful for this. Remember, this is a COVID time. So a relaxation given at this point to these type of people is certainly going to be more beneficial to the affordable segment of society. And I think it's an excellent move by the government. Number two, that the stamp duty and other benefits which was there have expired on 31st of December. So I think the timing of the move is also there to say that this industry benefit should continue. However, there has been a move from the housing minister that the benefit in terms of development cess and other charges should be continued at least for another period of 6 months. So we are looking forward to the Honorable Chief Minister that along with this benefit of 500 square feet apartments where the municipal taxes are waived, the benefit which expired on 31st, that is yesterday, should also be continued for a period of 6 months.
Okay, Mr. Hiranandani, thank you so much for joining us with those insights, with that analysis there. Mr. Hiranandani explaining the impact of this and what it means for the sector. My colleague Ketan still with us. Ketan, we were also discussing the politics of it, and there is no doubt a political subtext to this announcement.
Well, before that, a quick big numbers here, Aarti, that we are looking at 460 crore tax that BMC is not going to get after the move. However, the BMC is sitting on big coffers of money. They are expecting, they have set a target of 7,000 crore worth of property tax this year. Last year, because of COVID, they could only manage 4,500 crore of property tax. However, the real estate is buoyant this year. And also through the premium that they have charged, recently we saw that the BMC made the BMC earned 11,000 crore worth of tax. Now, the politics of it is out in the open. In another 2 months' time, we are looking at the Brihanmumbai Municipal Corporation election, where where Shiv Sena is in power, and this move will benefit the middle class. So clearly, there is a political angle to it. It is the middle class that votes for the Shiv Sena, and clearly, this benefit is aimed at real politics.
Okay, Ketan, thanks so much for that. A big move. Ketan explaining to us the politics, the finances and the economics of this. But information that's very crucial if you are a resident of Mumbai and are looking to own property or to buy property, news that you could use.